Should you buy a laptop with Nvidia's 1070 graphics or 1070 with Max-Q? We're going to benchmark two laptops in a number of games to see the performance differences between them to help you decide which you should get. The two laptops that I'm testing here are very close to being the same in terms of specs. Both have an Intel 7700 HQ quad-core CPU with 16GB of DDR4 memory and use an SSD for the primary hard drive, which is running Windows 10 with all available updates applied. No manual overclocking was performed for any of these tests, and G-Sync was disabled. The main difference between the two laptops is, of course, that one is running your standard Nvidia GeForce GTX 1070, while the other laptop has an Nvidia GeForce GTX 1070 with Max-Q design. The specs between these two graphics cards are slightly different. The main difference is that the Max-Q 1070 has lower base and boost clock speeds. And these are the ranges that Nvidia list on their website, and they state that the base and boost clock speeds depend on the particular laptop's thermal and electrical system design. So essentially, one laptop with a Max-Q graphics card can perform differently to another laptop that also has Max-Q graphics, so that's worth keeping in mind. I didn't have any thermal throttling in either laptop, so I don't believe this was a limitation here. As the regular 1070 has higher base and boost clock speeds, it also uses more power, meaning it will run hotter and require more cooling, resulting in more noise, and this is what Max-Q graphics aim to reduce. With that in mind, let's take a look at our benchmarks and find out how each of these cards perform. We'll cover both real-world gaming benchmarks first, and then the results of some benchmarking tools. All games were tested with the 1080p resolution using all available setting presets. Overwatch shows a fair improvement at max settings, although the difference gets much larger as you drop down in settings. Personally, I thought it was nice and smooth, even at epic settings on the Max-Q 1070, as even the 1% lows are above 60fps. And on average, over all setting levels, the 1070 performed around 34% better than the Max-Q 1070. Rise of the Tomb Raider was tested using the built-in benchmark with DirectX 12, and again we're seeing a larger difference at the lower setting levels. And even at max settings where the difference is the lowest, we're still seeing a 34% improvement with the 1070. PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds was tested with the latest 1.0 version using the replay feature, and this game showed the lowest difference between the two graphics cards, possibly because it just doesn't seem to be very well optimized. In my test, the 1070 is only performing 4% better than the Max-Q version. But of course, these results can vary quite a bit depending on what's going on in-game. Watch Dogs 2 is a fairly resource-intensive game, but it doesn't really need a high frame rate to enjoy, and it ran well at max settings with either laptop. On average, the 1070 is performing around 34% better than the Max-Q 1070 here. Ghost Recon was tested with the built-in benchmark tool and is another resource-intensive game. We're not getting great results at max settings, but it runs fairly well at very high or lower, and the 1070 performs around 21% better than the Max-Q 1070. In The Witcher 3, we're almost able to get 60fps even at max settings with the Max-Q 1070, and this game doesn't even really need a high frame rate to enjoy. On average, over all setting levels, the 1070 is performing 27% better than the Max-Q version in this game. Shadow of War, using the built-in benchmark, showed a fair improvement of around 31% on average between the two graphics cards, although we're able to average over 60fps at ultra settings even with the Max-Q 1070, so both are performing good. I've found Battlefield 1 to run quite well on most hardware, and even at max settings it ran smoothly on both laptops, as shown by the fairly high 1% lows. Once again, we can see the gap between the two get larger as the settings drop down. Even at max settings, the 1070 is performing 38% better than the Max-Q 1070. CSGO was also quite interesting. There was a huge difference between the two, with the 1070 performing 95% better on average. I ran these tests multiple times and can only presume that it's a well-optimized game. Dota 2 ran well on both laptops, although I'm testing with a fairly intensive replay here. We can see there's quite a nice performance increase when running with the 1070, around 37% better than the Max-Q 1070. Doom is another game that usually performs pretty well regardless of graphics power, and I've tested it using Vulkan, although there's not too much of a change between the setting levels. Again, the 1070 is performing around 37% better than the Max-Q version. Before we get into the benchmarking tools, I'll just quickly note the performance improvement over the games tested is a 32% increase for the 1070 over the Max-Q 1070. A pretty good result, and I didn't actually include the CSGO test as I'm still a bit unsure about that 95% improvement. It really seems to depend on the game. Now onto the benchmarking tools. While a useful indicator, note that these results are generally less practical compared to the real-world gaming tests previously shown. In the Heaven benchmark, the difference between the two graphics cards is fairly similar at all setting levels. Whereas in Valley Benchmark, the differences between the two are much closer together, with the Max-Q 1070 actually coming out slightly ahead at high settings. I've also tested the latest Superposition benchmark from Unigen, and again there's a similar increase. Finally, I've tested Firestrike and Time Spike benchmarks from 3D Mark, which showed a similar increase. On average, from these benchmark tools, the 1070 is performing just under 12% better than the Max-Q 1070, so not actually that much of a difference compared to the real-world gaming results, which was interesting. Usually the difference is much bigger. So as expected, the 1070 came out ahead of the Max-Q 1070 in just about every test, performing over 28% better on average in the games and benchmark tools shown here, a much bigger difference than I expected. To be honest, I thought the results would be closer, as the 1060 only showed an 8% improvement over the Max-Q 1060. It seems like it may be fairer to compare the Max-Q 1070 with the 1060, so make sure to subscribe for that one. If you've already got a laptop with the Max-Q 1070, is it worth upgrading to the full 1070? Although the performance difference is a fair amount, I'd generally say no, unless you really need it, as in most cases this would involve buying a completely new laptop, a fairly expensive process. If you're looking at buying a new laptop and trying to decide between either of these, then it depends more on the games you're wanting to play with them. Realistically, both offer a great experience at 1080p. Personally, I play most of the games tested earlier, so I'd lean towards the 1070, especially if I was playing on a monitor above 60Hz for the better experience at higher settings. But if you're playing less demanding games or have no issues dropping the settings down a little, the Max-Q 1070 still gives a great experience. The 1070 with Max-Q should use less power and produce less noise. However, as both of the laptops I've tested are completely different in terms of overall form factor, as they're from different companies, it wouldn't really be a fair comparison. Ideally, I'd need two laptops of the same brand and model to do that justice. With that said, the Max-Q 1070 ran at around the same temps as the 1070. However, it's also in a thinner body compared to the 1070 laptop. So in my case, I've got a thinner laptop, but the trade-off is that the temps and system volume aren't that much different from a regular 1070 laptop. I hope that these benchmarks have shown you the real-world differences in performance between the Nvidia 1070 and 1070 with Max-Q laptop graphics cards, and helped you choose between them. Let me know down in the comments which graphics card you'll be getting in your next laptop and why. And leave a like on the video if you found the information useful. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for future tech videos like this one.